Now, once we have depreciated the equipment, then there's another question that sometimes arises. And this has to do with additional expenditures. What happens many times is that after we buy an asset, later on, we sometimes decide to spend additional money on that asset. And when we do that, the question that arises is, how do we record that? Should we go ahead and expense that? Or should we capitalize it? Because remember, the plant assets themselves are actually being capitalized and depreciated. So the question is, how do we handle this? Well, what we have to ask ourselves is, the additional money that we spent on the asset, is that a repair or is that an improvement? If it is simply a repair, we will go ahead and expense the additional expenditure. But if it is an improvement, then we actually have to capitalize. And how would we tell the difference? Well, a repair, that insinuates that you are simply repairing the asset. You are simply getting it back into its original condition. Versus an improvement, which actually insinuates that you're actually going beyond a repair and you're actually improving the asset. And by improving it, you are extending its capabilities or you are extending its lifespan, something like that. So if that's the case, it would actually have to be capitalized rather than expensed. So to see a comparison and a contrast, we're going to have two examples. One will be a repair and one will actually be an improvement. So in this first example, we have a piece of equipment. It's a plant asset. We own it. We're probably already depreciating it. But what if we spent $1,000 on that equipment and it happens to be for a minor repair? Well, if that's the case, we can just go ahead and expense that amount. We will debit repairs expense, $1,000, and credit cash. And really, we would prefer to do that because the more we can expense, the less our taxes are going to be. So as long as that's classified as a minor repair, we can go ahead and do that, take that full expense all at once. But look at this as a contrast. Same exact situation. It's equipment, we own it, we're depreciating it, we're spending $1,000 on that equipment, but this time it's ever so slightly different. This time it's not simply repairing the equipment, but this time when we spend that $1,000, it's actually going to improve the equipment. It's going to expand the capabilities of the equipment. So if that's the case, GAAP requires us to capitalize this. So it's the same journal entry more or less, except for one difference. Rather than debit repair expense, I'm debiting equipment. I'm capitalizing that. And that's going to then go into the depreciation. So that's a different treatment. So we always have to ask ourselves that question, that every time we spend additional money on a plant asset, is it a repair or is it simply an improvement? If that's the case, it must be capitalized. Now, once we've talked about depreciation, we then need to talk about depletion. Depletion is very, very similar to depreciation, but there is a key difference. With depletion, it's not an asset or a plant asset. It's actually something else. It is a natural resource. Anytime a company has a natural resource, that must be depleted. And that is also a GAAP requirement. Now, when we say natural resource, what are we talking about? Well, we're talking about anything that occurs in nature. So it could be coal, it could be natural gas, oil, timber, silver, gold, whatever it might be. It is a naturally occurring resource. And if we own something like this, either the land or perhaps the rights to it, that is an asset, but it has to be depleted because over time, as we extract this resource, we are depleting it. So that must be calculated. Now, the good news about it is that it's very easy to calculate depletion because it's actually calculated exactly the same way as one of our depreciation methods. Remember, we had three methods. Well, one of them was called units of production. And look at this formula. Cost minus salvage value divided by total units available times total units extracted for the period. That is the depletion formula, but it's more or less exactly the same as the units of production formula. So to see this in an actual example, this company is going to spend $100,000 to acquire mineral rights. That's a natural resource. It has no salvage value. And, you know, that's to be expected. In fact, a lot of times with natural resources, they don't have a salvage value. Now, they estimate that there are 10,000 tons of a very valuable mineral. So we want to extract that and sell that. And in the current year, we have already extracted 1,000 tons of that material. So to calculate the depletion, we will just say cost 100,000, there's no salvage, divided by a total of 10,000 tons, times the 1,000 tons that we extracted this year. And that means that in year one, we're going to take $10,000 worth of depletion. And look at the titles. It's almost exactly the same as our depreciation journal entry. The only thing we have to change is the title. So instead of depreciation expense, it becomes depletion expense as a debit, and then a credit to accumulated depletion. So this is a GAAP requirement every single time we have a natural resource.